Did you know that Norway has its own Cape Canaveral? It's on Andøya next to Andenes, and you can visit it. Just outside Andenes, find the Andøya Space Centre. It's a very small space center that specializes in launching sounding rockets. These are rockets that fly on suborbital trajectories to study the high atmosphere. Those launched from Andenes are used to research the northern lights. The history of the launch site dates back to the 1960s. In 1962, Norway launched its first rocket, the Ferdinand 1, becoming the fourth country to cross the common line after Germany, the USA and the Soviet Union. In 1995, a rocket launch almost caused World War III. The Russian Air Force had been informed in time, as with every launch. The information was not passed on. President Boris Yeltsin even began to issue nuclear codes on the nuclear briefcase that had been activated. After a few minutes, it was realized that the missile was not heading towards Russia, and the alarm was called off. Today, there are a few launch periods each year when several rockets are launched. It's possible to watch the launches from the town, but they don't take place during the summer tourist season. Other activities include UAVs, LIDAR and radar measurements for atmospheric research, and a rocket test center. Andøya Space Centre also offers various programs for students from various Norwegian universities. For tourists, there is a visitor center. As I'm a big space nerd, I booked the behind-the-scenes tour, where you get to see the real stuff. As no one else showed up, I got a private tour. Unfortunately, the guide couldn't keep up with my knowledge of astronomy and spaceflight. I had to explain to her what the actual definition of the Kármán line was. I was shown around a bit, and then to the control center, which I was not allowed to film, but it's just a bunch of computer screens, and some communications hardware, nothing I wouldn't see in my day job. It was also not possible to go to the actual launch pad, the labs, or the rocket storage area, which means you don't get to see the good stuff. I'm sure she could have explained a lot of space stuff to normal people, but I knew about 95% of it. Only a few historical facts about the launch site were new to me. There is also a small exhibition about space, but it is not that interesting. They also showed a film where some pioneers from the 1960s actually tell how they launched the first rocket in the middle of a field, which is quite interesting. But Andøya Space has just expanded with the construction of Andøya Spaceport, where orbital rockets are launched. It will be the first place in Europe to launch orbital rockets. It is located further south on the west side of the island between Berget and Nøss. The road runs straight through the complex with the integration building on one side of the road and the pad and tank farm on the other. The site was inaugurated in November 2023, a few months after my visit. The first launch should be in 2025 at the earliest. There are plenty of good vantage points on the mountains that form a semicircle around the site. So that's it. We hope this video will help you decide if you want to visit Andøya Space. Check out our other videos about Vesterålen and Lofoten.